We don't believe in amnesties. Mass amnesties are against, you know, legal immigrants. In the moment, you know, you're taking away the chance of a legal immigrant to come, and you're giving that to somebody who already broke the law and failed to comply with American law. So the reason why we are against it mainly is because don't provide, you know, provide the amnesty to people who are here illegally. And of course, you know, the provision for border security are not real. We are not going to stop people coming here, you know, building fences and putting more troops in the border, especially when 40% of the people in the country are overstay visas. So even if you solve the problem of the southern border, you don't have a solution for 40% coming here overstaying their visa becoming legal.
Just to be clear, you are not anti-immigrant or anti-immigration per se. Your main problem with the bill, the Senate and possibly the House version, is, and I don't know if you use pathway to citizenship, you use amnesty. It's because you came to this country and earned your citizenship, and you think all immigrants, undocumented workers, should follow your path?
Well, I think anybody who wants to become a citizen of a country, the first thing you need to prove is that you respect the laws. So in this case, these people have been failing to comply with American laws. So I don't think these people deserve the privilege because they don't have the right. You don't walk into a country and after 5 years or 6 months or 10 years, you have a right to become American citizen or to stay. You're not taking away the chance to somebody who is outside waiting, respecting your laws, and you are giving that chance to somebody who already broke it.
I'd like to begin by saying that the pathway to legalization leads to permanent resident status. There are three tracks, none of which are short. The longest is at a minimum 13 years. They have to be in permanent resident status for at least 10 years. They have to pay fines, penalties, back taxes, undergo multiple criminal background checks at various steps in the process. After 3 years of having the 10-year permanent resident card, they may be eligible for citizenship. This is not a 5-month or, you know, 6-month process. It's a very long, arduous, and expensive process. And I believe during that time, it provides these undocumented immigrants with the possibility and the chance to actually follow the laws of this country. Currently, the laws don't provide any option for them.
You would say then that the details that you spelled out to us are the pathway to legalization or the pathway to citizenship?
That is, yes, that is one. I would call it more of a roadmap.
What's the corresponding definition in your mind of amnesty then?
Amnesty is something I would define as much more immediate. There's not really the number of steps that's required. It is an immediate pardon, if you will. Amnesty and pardon can be interchangeable, but the outline in this bill is for a very long, tough road for people. They have to have squeaky clean criminal records. They have to make sure that they're above the poverty guidelines at all times. They have to show they're gainfully employed. There are English requirements, civics requirements. This is something that's far beyond what amnesty would be.
Let me just split the hair here just a little bit on that, because looking at her definition, there may be amnesty in the bill because they are the people who are here illegally are giving a legal status immediately. Now, it's not citizenship, but it's a status that allows them to stay here in the country legally and then move forward on this pathway to citizenship. So if her definition is that broad, that it's an immediate sort of reaction, then I would have to say that there is amnesty in this bill. And that's where you're going to see a lot of pushback from House Republicans, is that immediate legal status. And I don't know what the answer to that question is. You know, Mitt Romney talked about self-deportation, and I don't know if that's going to happen, barring some drastic measures to make it just unaffordable for them to stay. But that's the issue that you're going to see a lot of pushback from the House, is that immediate legal status.
But if I could, I just want to point out that for many people, for millions of people living in the country, there is no pathway, there is no opportunity for them to become legal. And let me give you an example. I work with a young man, Sagar. He's from India. He's a student here at U of L, well, in Louisville at U of L. And his family came here legally. They had visas, they entered the country the right way, and they played by the rules. They petitioned for permanent residency, and this is a lengthy process. Already it's a lengthy process. And eventually, after years and years of living in the country, his father was denied. Now, Sagar's lived in the United States for almost a decade. He's graduated from American high schools. His educational credits would not transfer with him to India. So this is an example of one of the 40,000 that Luis described who entered legally. And now there's no way for them to remain in the country. They're in this permanent limbo. You know, what is the practical solution to these types of problems? And I think, you know, what you've described, it's not amnesty to go through all these jumps and hoops.
Well, I would differ just to agree. There is a way for them to do it, but it's leaving the country first and then coming back in through the process. Now,
maybe.
Whether or not that's fair
or whether or not
that takes too long is another question, but there is a way for them to go about doing it legally, which is the way Luis came into the country.
They've exhausted every resource. They've spent thousands of dollars on legal fees. People have to understand, for some individuals, there is no legal way for them to adjust their status.